fellow scientists, it's Justin again. Learning about the water cycle made me super thirsty, so I thought, what better way to quench my thirst than to make some lemonade? Mio, you want to try some? What, you really don't like it? Well, yeah, it's salty. I made it with salt water. There's so much of it on Earth, so I figured, oh, why not? Ugh. Okay, I guess I understand what Mia means, but isn't all water the same? Why can't I use salt water to make lemonade? Or at least, good lemonade. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to identify where water is found on Earth, compare salt water and fresh water, and explain some ways to protect the Earth's water. Let's investigate. Even though we Earth scientists spend a lot of time studying land, like rocks, mountains, and volcanoes, our planet is mostly covered in water. In fact, 71% of Earth's surface is water. Imagine a chocolate bar cut into 10 pieces. If this chocolate bar were the surface of the Earth, 7 of its 10 pieces would be water. That's a lot of soggy chocolate. But all that water isn't spread across the Earth evenly. Take a look at this world map. Where do you see the most water? When I look at this map, I see a whole lot of blue. That's because most of the water on Earth is in the oceans. The oceans make up a whopping 97% of Earth's water supply. That's a ton of water. The oceans are so big that they stretch across the globe, covering the huge areas between continents. If you traveled by boat, you could sail for weeks without ever seeing land. So, 97% of water is found in the oceans. Some quick math tells us that that leaves only 3% of Earth's water in other places. No wonder it's hard to spot on a map this big. But if we zoom in a bit, there we go. Now what sources of water do you notice? The first bodies of water that stand out to me are the Great Lakes, here between the United States and Canada. A lake is a large body of water surrounded by land. Lakes can be found all over the world, but the Great Lakes are some of the very largest. If we look a little closer, we'll also see rivers, long, winding bodies of water that flow over the land. Unlike lakes, which stay in one place, rivers are always moving, carrying water from one place to another. But lakes and rivers aren't the only places we find water on Earth. Some of it is actually hidden underground. Even though we can't see it, water is stored beneath the Earth's surface in the spaces between rocks and soil. This is called groundwater. So, most of the Earth is covered in water. It's in oceans, lakes, rivers, and even underground. But is all that water the same? Even though my disastrous lemonade didn't quench my thirst, it did leave me with a scientist's favorite thing, a question. When life gives you salty lemons, right? If water is everywhere, why can't we just use any water for drinking, cooking, or most importantly, making lemonade? It turns out not all water is the same. Some water is fresh water, like the water we drink, and some is salt water. Salt water contains dissolved salt, and a lot of it. Have you ever been to the ocean and accidentally gotten a gulp of seawater? Or maybe you've tried gargling with salt water at home. How'd it taste? Not very refreshing, right? Salt water has a very, well, salty taste that can be pretty gross. The salt also makes it unsafe for humans to drink. Instead of quenching your thirst, drinking a lot of salt water would actually make your body thirstier. Salt water is what fills the oceans, which means that almost all water on Earth is salt water. Only 3% of the water on Earth is fresh water. If all of Earth's water could fit in a 1 gallon jug, only about 1 tablespoon of it would be fresh water. Fresh water has very little or no salt at all, making it safe for humans to drink and good for things like cooking, farming, and not ruining lemonade. Unlike salt water, which is mainly in the ocean, fresh water is found flowing in rivers and lakes, frozen in glaciers, and buried deep underground. We rely on fresh water every single day, often without even thinking about it. How do you use fresh water? Pause the video and record your thoughts in your guided notes. What uses did you think of? On top of drinking, cooking, and watering plants, I use fresh water when I take a shower or brush my teeth, when I wash the dishes, and definitely when I play in the sprinkler in the summer. We use fresh water in a ton of different ways, which makes it so wild to think that such a small portion of Earth's water supply is fresh water. In fact, there's even less for us to use than it seems. Even though 3% of water on Earth is fresh water, less than 1% of that is easily reachable on the surface in rivers, lakes, and streams. The rest is underground or locked away in glaciers and ice caps, frozen solid in places like Antarctica and Greenland. That means most of Earth's fresh water is out of reach. Even though fresh water is needed for life, only a tiny fraction of it is actually available for us to use. This makes it clear, fresh water is precious. We have to be thoughtful about how we use it. Water is more than just something we drink. It's essential for all life on Earth. Every living thing, from tiny bugs to giant elephants, depends on water to survive. Without it, we wouldn't have food to eat, crops wouldn't grow, and animals wouldn't have water to drink. Water is everywhere, but now we know that only a tiny amount is fresh and usable. That means we have to take care of what we have. The good news? There are two big ways to do that: conserving water and keeping it clean. Conserving water means using less so no water goes to waste. Small actions can make a big difference. Turning off the water while brushing your teeth, taking shorter showers, and fixing leaky faucets might not seem like much, but over time, these small choices add up. But conserving water isn't enough on its own. We also have to keep it clean. If our water sources get polluted, they can become dangerous for people and the environment. That's why it's important to pick up trash, be careful with household chemicals, and even clean up after our pets. Everything that washes into drains eventually makes its way back to our water sources. Water is precious, and we all have a responsibility to protect it. Whether it's using less water or keeping it clean, our choices help make sure there's enough water for everyone. Let's review everything we've learned today. Most of the Earth is covered in water, but not all of it's usable. 97% of Earth's water is salt water found in the oceans. Only 3% of Earth's water is fresh water found in lakes, rivers, glaciers, and underground. Most fresh water is out of reach, which means less than 1% of Earth's water is available for drinking and daily use. That's why it's important to conserve water and keep it clean. To learn more about water on Earth, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. Well, lesson learned. Salt water and lemonade do not mix. I think I'll leave the ocean where it belongs and stick to fresh water for my future refreshment needs. Keep exploring, scientists. There's always more to discover beneath the surface. See you next time. Hey.